Hi everyone, Corrie Sommers here. Today on Close With Corrie, we're gonna get into the topic of should you sell your home or should you rent it out? Be sure to stay tuned for all the tidbits as to what you need to know if you're going to rent your home. Hi again. So today's topic is should you sell or rent your home? Now, even though I sell real estate, I am a proponent. If you can keep your home and you don't have to sell it in order to buy, hold on to that. Real estate is one of the largest vehicles that accumulates wealth over your lifetime. And if you can hold on to it, do so. But there are things that you do need to know if you are going to become a landlord, especially here in the state of California. We are about to get into the top five things, the top five changes effective 2019 that you need to know. Okay, everyone. So the number one thing that has changed in California in 2019 is that if you are a landlord and you are going to be renting out your home or property, condo, whatnot, you must disclose if it is in a flood zone. Now, some of you are thinking, I bought my home 10 years ago, 20 years ago, how do I know? You could contact an NHD company and get a report for a small fee. One company you could reach out to is MyNHD. I actually have a video with them and their rep, and they are an excellent company. Or you could also go on to FEMA's website and plug in your address and take a look and see. That's not a bad place at all to go. If it was me though, I'd rather be safe than sorry. And so I would definitely contact my NHD and get a flood report done on your property. The second item you need to be aware of if you are going to be renting out your property, whether it's a home or a condo, is that you need to have low flow plumbing fixtures. This is your toilet, this is your shower. It's just all those things that involve your plumbing. State of California is really kind of clamped down on that. We need to conserve water here, and that's the solution, low flow. If you are going to be renting out your property, the third item you need to be aware of is things have changed with the 3-day notice to quit. So previously, the 3-day notice to perform or quit, meaning your tenant hasn't paid their rent on time, and so you're issuing that demand, was 3 days. It is now 3 business days. So if you issue that demand on a Friday, Friday is the first business day. Saturday and Sunday no longer count. They have Monday and Tuesday. By the end of business day Tuesday, that hits your 3 business days. So something to keep in mind as well. So the fourth item to be aware of if you are going to be renting your property is that any monies received via check must be accompanied by a statement. So if your tenant tends to mail you a check, there needs to be some sort of letter accompanying saying that these funds is for the rent of property such and such. If somebody else is covering this, perhaps you're renting to a woman who's divorced and her ex-husband is paying it and he mails you that check, there must be a statement stating that these funds are for the rent for such and such property. Make sure your tenants are doing that. This is something that's not yet enforced, but you don't want to get kind of caught in the jumble if they suddenly crack down on this and you don't have your paper trail to show. So the fifth item that has changed in the state of California when it comes to renting your property is actually more concerned with multi-units. So if you own 3 units or more, whether that's a triplex or an apartment building, there's a couple of things that you need to be aware of to be compliant. The first is if there's an exterior balcony or stairs that are at least 6 feet off the ground, these now have to be inspected every 6 years by someone with a structural engineering company, etc., and you need to have that paperwork. If they audit you and you don't show that you've had this inspected every 6 years by a structural engineer, that's going to be a problem. There could be fines involved, etc. So if you own a condo or just a home, a single family home, this is not something you need to worry about. This is more for people that own a 3-family or an apartment complex, something of that nature. So hopefully these 5 new tips are helpful to you. These are all changes that have happened in the state of California this year, effective July 2019. If you are now thinking, I'm not sure if I want to rent out my property, maybe I want to sell, we can have a conversation about that. No charge, no free consultation, just getting together and kind of talking about your situation and figuring out if selling is really the best move for you or not. I am always here to help. And be sure to click below for a guide on top things to be aware of as a landlord. You want to protect yourself and protect your property. I'm always here for you. This is Corrie Sommers. Thank you for watching today's Close with Corrie. If you have not yet subscribed, be sure to subscribe below and click that bell. Until next time, have a great day.